Hello dear students, today we will be talking about the part 2 of our lesson about one-dimensional motion. Free fall motion. The displacement, velocity and acceleration of an object can also be calculated even on a vertical motion. This is known as free fall motion. A free falling object is an object that is falling under the sole influence of gravity. Any object that is being acted upon only by the force of gravity is said to be in a state of free fall. There are two important motion characteristics that are true of free-falling objects. Free-falling objects do not encounter air resistance. All free-falling objects on Earth accelerate downwards at a rate of 9.8 meters per second, often approximated as 10 meters per second for back-of-the-envelope calculations. Acceleration is the rate at which an object changes its velocity. It is the ratio of velocity change to time between any two points in an object's path. To accelerate at 9.8 meters per second means to change the velocity by 9.8 meters per second each second. Notice the acceleration. 9.8 meters per second has a negative sign indicating that this acceleration is going downward. If the velocity and time for a free-falling object being dropped from a position of rest were tabulated, then one would note the following pattern. For time 0, the velocity is 0. For time 1 second, the velocity is 9.8 meters per second. For time 2 seconds, the velocity is 19.6 meters per second. For time 3 seconds, the velocity is 29.4 meters per second. For time 4 seconds, the velocity is 39.2 meters per second. For time 5 seconds, the velocity is 149.0 meters per second. Observe that the velocity time data above reveal that the object's velocity is changing by 9.8 meters per second each consecutive second. That is, the free-falling object has an acceleration of approximately 9.8 meters per second per second. Another way to represent this acceleration of 9.8 meters per second per second is our dot diagram. The velocity of the ball is seen to increase as depicted in the diagram at the right. Note, the diagram is not drawn to scale. In 2 seconds, the object would drop considerably further than the distance from shoulder to toes. We can also represent free fall with a graph. Observe that the line on the graph curves. A curved line on a position versus time graph signifies an accelerated motion. Since a free-falling object is undergoing an acceleration, g equals 9.8 meters per second per second, it would be expected that its position time graph would be curved. A further look at the position time graph reveals that the object starts with a small velocity, slow, and finishes with a large velocity, fast. Since the slope of any position versus time graph is the velocity of the object, the small initial slope indicates a small initial velocity and the large final slope indicates a large final velocity. Finally, the negative slope of the line indicates a negative, i.e., downward, velocity. The formula for determining the velocity of a falling object after a time of t seconds is v sub f equals gt, dropped from rest. Where g is the acceleration of gravity. The value for g on Earth is 9.8 meters per second per second. The above equation can be used to calculate the velocity of the object after any given amount of time when dropped from rest. Let's have an example. Calculations for the velocity of a free-falling object after 6 and 8 seconds are shown below. At t equals 6 seconds, v sub f is equals to 9.8 meters per second square times 6 seconds. We get the final velocity at t equals 6 as 58.8 meters per second. At t equals 8 seconds, v sub f is equals to 9.8 meters per second square times 8 seconds. We get the final velocity at t equals 8 as 78.4 meters per second. The distance that a free-falling object has fallen from a position of rest is also dependent upon the time of fall. This distance can be computed by use of a formula. The distance fallen after a time of t seconds is given by the formula. D equals 0.5 grams t squared. Where g is the acceleration of gravity. Second example, calculations for the distance fallen by a free-falling object after 1 and 2 seconds are shown below. At t equals 1 second, d is equals 0.5 times 9.8 times 1 second squared. D is equals 4.9 meters. At t equals 2 seconds, d is equals 0.5 times 9.8 times 2 seconds squared. D is equals 19.6 meters. At t equals 5 seconds, d is equals 0.5 times 9.8 times 5 seconds squared. D is equals 122.5 meters. That ends our second part. Have a nice day.